a comprehensive look at trends, fund profiles, and more in Exploring ETFs.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to Exploring ETFs. I'm Neena Mishra, and today we are talking about chip stocks and ETFs and all these semiconductor stocks. They are surging today. They are bouncing back very strongly and partly recovering their losses from Friday. And that's mainly due to easing of US-China trade tensions after President Trump's post on social media, and also a big AI deal between Broadcom and OpenAI. And we have seen so many of these deals lately. We'll talk about them and what those deals mean for these stocks. But these stocks and ETFs, they have been shining, they have been surging for the past couple of years, past 2-3 years at least, because these are the picks and shovels for the AI gold rush. And so they are the biggest beneficiaries so far of the AI bonanza. And in fact, these ETFs are among the best performing ETFs of the past decade, because chips have become essential in everything from smartphones, cars, PCs, video games, data centers. So if you look at the performance of the most popular chip ETF, you will see that it has returned 31% annualized for the past 10 years. Such an impressive performance. Now let's talk about some of these deals. So Nvidia, which is the clear AI leader, AI darling. So Nvidia announced a strategic partnership with OpenAI, under which Nvidia will invest up to $100 billion in OpenAI. And this investment will support new data centers with a capacity of at least 10 gigawatt of power capacity. Then AMD stock has been skyrocketing over the past couple of weeks or so, because they announced an agreement with OpenAI on data centers that will use AMD's chips. So under this deal, OpenAI will purchase 6 gigawatt of AMD gigawatts worth of AMD chips, and it will also receive a 10% equity stake in AMD, which will be granted in phases upon reaching certain milestones. Now, AMD was underperforming earlier because it has long been viewed as a very distant second in the AI chip market, which is dominated by Nvidia with a more than 75% market share. Now, AMD is trying to get back in the race, and so this agreement was huge for them and for Lisa Su, the CEO. Now, today we heard about this partnership between Broadcom and OpenAI, and we didn't get the financial terms, but this would be about 10 gigabytes of custom AI chips and systems over the next 4 years. So that's also huge. And looking at Intel, Intel was a laggard earlier because they lost in the mobile revolution, they lost in the AI revolution, and they also lost the edge to Taiwan Semiconductor, TSMC. TSMC is now the world's largest and most advanced chip maker. But both the Biden administration and Trump administration, they have been trying to support Intel because they want to strengthen domestic chip manufacturing. And recently, the Trump administration announced a 10% equity stake in Intel, and that stake is now up over 50% in value because the stock has gone up. Nvidia also announced $5 billion investment in Intel, and the Trump administration has been asking other companies, also reportedly asking other companies, other tech giants, to support Intel. Now, talking about all these huge computing deals and announcements, so according to OpenAI's own estimates, and other experts also believe that 1 gigabyte of capacity costs about $50 billion to bring online, of which about 2/3 is spent on chips, hardware, and infrastructure, and that is according to an FT article. So you can just imagine the size of this compute market, and also what that means for all these chip makers, because so much will be spent on these chips. And as I had mentioned in a recent video earlier, that this is a race to artificial general intelligence, AGI, and that is why the tech giants, they are continuing to expand, and no one wants to be left behind. Now let's take a look at the competitive performance of these major players in the chip market, and then we will talk about the ETFs. So Nvidia is actually one of the worst performers this year because others have done so well. Intel is up 81% year to date, and who would have imagined that? AMD is up 78%, Broadcom 41%, and it will be even more after today's surge. TSMC is up 43%, Nvidia a cool 37%, even though it is the worst performer of this group. Now, let's take a look at the three popular chip ETFs, and they are quite different from one another because of the way they weight these holdings in the portfolio, and that has resulted in some divergence in performance as well. Now, the VanEck Semiconductor ETF, ticker symbol SMH, is the most popular chip ETF with $32.4 billion in assets, charges 35 basis points. It holds 25 major chip companies, the world's largest chip companies, and follows a market cap weighting scheme. If you want to learn more about this ETF, an easy way is to go to the quote page on Zacks.com. You can read our research report, articles, and using the link, you can go to VanEck webpage for this ETF. And if you look at the holdings, Nvidia is the top holding with almost 19% weight in the portfolio, and then Taiwan Semi 10%, Broadcom 8%, AMD about 6%, Intel is also about 6% in the portfolio. The second ETF that I'm highlighting is by iShares. The ticker symbol is SOXX. This follows a modified market cap weighting scheme. So it has about 30 holdings, and it places a cap of 8% on those individual securities. And this has $14.4 billion in assets, similar expense ratio, 34 basis points. Let's go to the quote page using the link on Zacks.com, and you will see that similar holdings, but different weighting because of the cap. And AMD is the top holding currently, but at the time of the rebalancing, every holding will be brought back to the cap of 8%. So current top holdings are AMD, Broadcom, Nvidia, and Micron Technologies. Incidentally, Micron is the top performing chip maker year to date, and this is up more than 100%, and then Intel. Now the third ETF that I'm highlighting, that follows an equal weighting scheme. So if you don't want a top heavy ETF and you want to benefit from
all the holdings, search in all the holdings, and maybe take a look at this ETF XSD by State Street. And this has about 40 holdings, which, as I mentioned, equal weighted, 1.7 billion in assets, similar expense ratio. And again, you can use the link on Zacks.com to go to State Street webpage for this ETF. The top holding here is Rigetti Computing, which is also actually a quantum computing stock. And then you have Intel, AMD, Micron, Marvel, Rambus. So some slightly different top holdings and weightings for this ETF. But again, these all will be brought back to equal weights at the time of rebalancing. The surge in Rigetti has brought it to the top of the portfolio. Now, on the next slide, I have the comparative performance versus the S&P 500 index. So the VNEC ETF SMH is the top performer year to date with a gain of 34%. The other two ETFs that we talked about are up about 27% year to date. And in full disclosure, I own SOXX in the ETF investor portfolio that I manage. And the S&P 500 index is up about 11-12% year to date.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to check out Zacks.com/promo for an interesting offer. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube video channel so that you do not miss anything. And I'll see you next week.